And she's in blue.
Hello, Master.
Get out of the bottle. I command you.
Nice.
You look ridiculous.
I feel ridiculous.
She looks good.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, right? I thought she was an innocent. How was I to know that I was going to unleash a demon?
It says so right here.
It says
right, right there, in Arabic.
It says whoever tried to free her, they'd have to switch places with her.
How come your empathy thing didn't give her away?
She tricked me, and obviously the book too.
Chris is coming back up there with me. The elders have agreed to send him back to his time.
No, what? Not yet.
You don't know what you're doing.
Not yet.
You don't belong here. And as your white lighter, he's doing more harm than good.
This isn't about me being a bad white lighter. It's about you feeling like I've let you down somehow. I wish you would just get over it already.
Oh, I wish.
Leo? Of course I forgive you, man. You don't have to yell.
Yeah.
All you gotta do is ask. Because I'll talk to the other elders and we're gonna work it all out, okay? It's no big deal, okay? Come on, give me a hug.
It's so weird seeing Leo like this.
Bottom line is we need you home now.
Well, I can't. I'm kind of in the middle of saving Richard right now.
No, who are this? His entire family?
I thought most of his relatives are dead.
Uh-huh, they are.
What about his crazy ex-girlfriend?
Hey, maybe since you have all those ghosts there, you could get one to help us out when you're done.
Let's do what?
Surprise! Happy birthday!
What are they doing here?
Your family is here because they care about you.
We need you to listen to us. I died because of the magic. Can't let yourself end up like that.
I can make you a power stripping potion. It'll turn you back into yourself.
Nope. See you later.
Have you found the location of the lost city yet?
We believe we've discovered the site.
Now all I need is that bottle. Gather your best fighters. We're going on a witch hunt.
What are you doing, Leo?
Hey, Piper says to hurry up with those crystals. Jean and Phoebe's getting on her last nerves down there. I'm writing you an apology.
An apology?
I get it right. We gotta go help the sisters. All right, well, in a minute. This is just as important.
Come on.
Dear Chris.
Come on, you.
You said you're sorry. Let's just not go overboard. I feel like I owe it to you. Honestly, a letter's not gonna mean a hell of a lot to me. I got plenty of them growing up. Sorry?
He wasn't there.
From my father. He wasn't around much. You want to talk about it? No! What I want from you is to grab the crystals and go downstairs to where Piper is.
He did have a little line earlier in the episode where he was like, something about being abandoned again. So it seems like he has father issues with Leo not being around when he was growing up. But not dead, just not around. Hence the letters. For whatever reason. How is this all going to resolve? How do Piper and Leo get back together without... I feel like it has to happen. I feel like it will happen naturally if we just stand back.
Sure.
You two need to get back together already. Any chance that's going to happen?
I don't think so. But thanks for caring, man. It means a lot.
Leo still loves her, though.
Wait.
Right?
You still love her. I know you do.
It's a little personal, don't you think?
Yeah, more than you know.
We both moved on, and nothing short of a miracle could make
it. A miracle. We need a miracle. Yes. Don't use your wish.
Did you find us a ghost?
Yeah, I got us Richard's dad. Why do we need a ghost?
Well, once we capture Ginny, he can possess her and force her to wish Phoebe free.
Right.
Here's the crystals you wanted.
I love the way they came in laughing together.
Sure. Guys, there's something I have to tell you.
After we talk in the kitchen, Phoebe.
Me?
Well, that was cool.
What's he hiding now?
Big secrets.
I'll get it.
Big secrets.
Hey,
Richard.
Richard.
What you doing here?
What are you doing here?
Come to apologize?
I came to apologize.
No, flowers.
You wanna make them do what?
This is the perfect time to hit him with the whammy.
No, we are not.
This is such a bad idea.
I wish for Piper and Leah to sleep together tonight.
Oh.
I'm not.
Are they doing it right now? Right now?
What was that?
Oh, they're sleeping together.
You tricked me.
No, you made me wish for them to sleep together.
This is a mess.
Genie trickster.
I've only got one more wish to sort this thing out, so if you don't mind, I command you back into the bottle.
When I get out of this...
Genie rules are slightly confusing. You get 3 wishes, but you also have complete command over the person, right? While you're their master. So The difference between a command and a wish. Is a wish something that can only happen through magical means? And a command is, I command you to walk into the kitchen. I command you to agree with me. You know, what's the difference between a wish and a command? What I do know about witches is that they always trick you. They always twist it a little bit. You're never quite sure what you're going to get.
It's me or magic. You just have to choose one.
You can't give me that kind of choice.
I just did. Oh! Wait here.
I have to pause this straight away for Paige and Richard. Paige is giving Richard an ultimatum. Me or magic. You'd imagine it would be the other way around. Like, from a few weeks ago, he's trying to stay away from magic. Paige is trying not to do magic in front of him. But she's the super magical witch. She is the queen of magic. Magic surrounds her. She is magic. So you can imagine him saying to her, look, it's either me or magic. You know, because I can't be around you because it's going to affect things. So far, again, we haven't seen Richard, although he's been kind of weird with the giving her gifts suddenly. He hasn't done anything crazy. I was expecting dark shit, you know? You know, kind of the stuff that Cole was doing near the end. It'd be funny if they just break up in this episode and we never see him again. Because he'd be a really funny arc to think back on. Remember that guy who apparently had a magic problem, but we never saw anything like that? And then he just left? Anyway, what's going on? What's this all about? Oh.
Find the bottle. Phoebe's inside.
Sorry!
Get killed, dude. Oh, there she is. Get her, get her. Stop her, Richard.
Circle.
Ah, you're stuck.
Got her.
Where's the bottle?
Where is the bottle? Oh, Richard has it?
Richard?
Here we go. Here we go. He's fine. We're finally seeing something evil from Richard. There.
What's wrong with them?
It's a long story.
I don't know. Why don't you give me the Cliff Notes version? You and Leo and Phoebe have all been acting weird since before the
demon
attacked.
He's
going
to tell her.
I made a little wish.
What?
Yeah.
Did you wish for?
For Piper and Leo to sleep together.
You are sick.
No.
Oh,
I'm Piper
God,
and Leo's son.
So gross. What?
Yeah.
I came back to save my family.
And this has been such a long day.
I'm gonna orb over to Richard's, okay? And grab the bottle.
You can't. He's crazy right now. He might hurt you, okay? I need to strip him of his powers. Who else knows about this?
About me? Just Phoebe.
All right, you watch Ginny. I'm gonna go make this potion, okay?
Okay. Right. Two people go now.
Come on!
She's trying to roll it? She's doing it. Yeah! Nice.
I thought a demon got me.
Paige, I told you, don't orb in and surprise me.
How come you didn't tell me Chris was my nephew?
We can talk about that later. Richard knows.
Boyfriend's about to woo-woo!
Look, I'm fine, all right? Call you when I'm ready.
This is for your own good.
Oh.
Paige.
He hurt her. It had to happen eventually. Hey, Greg.
Aren't you supposed to be at work or something?
There's a fire.
Her name is Price Piper. Sorry, she's sleeping. I don't believe you. Okay, see for yourself.
Whoa. Greg's not gonna like this. That's cheap, Chris.
Do you want to tell him you stopped by? No, that won't be necessary.
He's going off to have a drink with Dan. Is she free? Shit.
Take me to the bottle.
He's gonna.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to.
It's okay, it's fine.
I'll make it up to you.
No more wishes.
It's not for me. Phoebe, I wish you free.
Oh, does he have to be the genie now?
Genie, I wish the charmed one's dead.
Oh, Richard.
No!
Now, into the bottle.
Oh, crap. This went sideways.
My condolences.
Maybe they're just dead tired.
It's not your time. I know it's not your time.
Oh, they're in the spirit realm. Grab him. Grab him.
I'm so sorry. This is all my fault. She was gonna kill Mom and Dad.
Mm-hmm. Oh no. Leo, wake up.
Leo, get it. Wake up, dude. Oh.
But how?
Is he magically healing her? With love? In his sleep?
We're not moving on. Why aren't we moving on?
Guys, we can fix this. We can reverse the magic. All we need to do is get the bottle.
You sure this is a site?
One of the hounds of the Zanbar.
Ooh.
They guarded the city for the Sultan.
You ready in there?
Wish number two.
I wish to resurrect the lost city of Zanbar.
Is it gonna come up out of the ground? Do we have the budget for that? Oh. Ooh. Nice.
Finders keepers.
I wouldn't unpack just now if I were you.
You're dead. So are you.
Oh, right into her. Right into her.
Richard, I wish you free.
Right. And now she's gonna... Yeah. That makes sense. And then we can...
Hi, honey.
Command her to bring them back to life.
I wish the charmed ones alive again.
See you later. Now what, Richard?
You okay?
Take this. Get it out of my sight.
Sure.
Yeah, don't let him...
Could you get rid of that thing first?
No problem.
But it's cool looking. Can we just keep it there?
How can you have so much faith, Paige?
Well, it's because I don't just see all the evil. I see all the good, too.
Mm-hmm.
Especially in you.
Well, I hope you're right, because I'm giving up a lot.
Well, you have to take care of yourself first, right? And as long as I'm around and bringing magic into your life...
Oh, we're breaking up.
You won't be able to.
I know.
The worst of all worlds, binding him and...
Have you taken the power stripping potion
and
yet?
Breaking him. Will I empty the bottle? Does that count?
Mm. Hey, you okay?
What are you doing?
I don't know. What's going on?
Arabic sleeping potion, very strong, not good.
Jenny did this?
Yeah, Jenny.
Who else? He's back in the bottle.
Which we were sort of hoping you could take care of for us.
I still want to know why we all didn't die.
Leo.
I was floating over my body, looking down at me, and then, you healed me.
I did?
Yeah. You wouldn't let me go.
Mm-hmm.
Well, then that must be the reason why Phoebe and Paige's spirits didn't move on.
That was really sweet of you.
Dear.
Anytime. So, you want to go with me to get Wyatt?
Sure.
What about me?
I wouldn't give up. There may be hope for you yet.
Yeah, she can read the room. She's been paying attention. Poor Greg, though. Greg doesn't deserve any of this. Do you know? You know what I mean? Greg's just on the wrong side of the plot. Unless he's secretly Chris's father. You don't know. He could be. But Chris and Leo have such a father-son dynamic. So that was an episode about a genie. I Dream of Phoebe. And it was very silly, but very entertaining. I really liked that one. And, hey look, I think that's the last time we'll see Richard. At least, what I'll say about Richard is that we don't need to see him anymore. Unlike Jason and Phoebe, this did feel like a goodbye. Because having her in his life, but if he has no powers then, I don't know, don't question it. Don't think about it. But my favorite thing about the whole Richard plot is that it was a sort of made up, sort of completely and utterly made up problem that he had with magic. And sure, in this one episode, right at the end, He was starting to act a bit shady. Grabbing the bottle. Trying to make a wish so that Paige would be okay with him having her. Do you know what the funny thing is about Richard and that wish? It's like he's trying to convince the writers that it's okay that he uses magic. It's okay. Look, loads of people use magic. Can't I also use magic without it being a big thing? Apparently not. The only thing he did, as far as I can remember across this entire arc, is when he pushed Paige away in this episode and she, I don't know if she hit her head or whatever. Everything else was just fine. The gifts, keep the gifts coming. He helped at the end. You know, he stopped Ginny. He selflessly gave up his powers in the end. He didn't, there wasn't a huge amount of pushback. But his whole story seemed to happen off screen. It seemed to happen in stories. It seemed to happen in other people talking about it. It was a lot of tell and not a lot of show with him. And part of me, as I said, thinks that he's only in the show, that actor and that character, because of his name. Because of the actor's name. So, if that is the last time we see him, oh, great, great. I'll have a lot of fun talking about him in future and remembering him. And his stupid family, his absolutely god-awful stupid family. We saw half of them in this episode, half alive, half dead. And they weren't helpful one bit. We didn't see his ex-girlfriend, ex-wife. She had moved on or something. We couldn't summon those. But I love the genie stuff in this. Everything was very fun and consistent about people making wishes, wishing the genie out, and getting, you have to swap places with them. Commands versus wishes. How we outsmarted the villain in the end by being a ghost and going into her and forcing her to make a wish. Good thing that worked. It could have worked in a different way. It could have made, it was Phoebe who was inside her, right? It could have made Phoebe the genie again, because it was Phoebe was the one controlling her and saying the words. But then it'd be like a ghost genie. That'd be weird. But it was great. Phoebe looked great. Phoebe looked great. I thought she looked silly in a few episodes ago when she was wrecking Jason's entire career. But in this one, it was just classic genie outfit. And it was very funny. They were all making fun of it. They were all having a great time this episode. And Chris's increasingly desperate attempts to get Leo and Piper together were funny. I love that everybody, like, Paige knows now. I like that. I like that some people know and some people don't. I like that we're following Phoebe's lead. I like that the sleeping wish was kind of subverted. I love that when she wished them all dead, that Leo saved one of them, therefore the wish broke. You know? Leo's like, hey, not so fast. Not so fast. even though he was asleep. He kind of sensed Piper calling to him. And Phoebe picks up on, hey, Phoebe's super empath. So, although no, Piper's taking the potion. I keep forgetting that. I was going to say she's picking up on the feelings of both Leo and Piper in the room. So she will know if there's any connection forming again. She'll be able to sense it from Leo, because I don't think Leo took any potion. It was just Chris and Piper and Phage. I almost called her Phage. Hey, can I say, after 6 seasons, I don't think I've ever mentioned this before, but when talking about the sisters, because all of their names start with P, it takes me a little second to pick the right name. You'd think after 6 seasons, I'd just be easily able to say who is who. the names would just not ever be an issue, but for some reason it is. I think it's because they're all P's, you know? Because my brain instantly thinks P and then connects, it takes a little extra time. So sometimes I'll say Phoebe when I mean Paige, and Paige when I mean Phoebe. For some reason. I wonder if anybody else has that problem. It's easier for me to have that problem because I'm always talking. I'm constantly talking about the show. But just something I noticed. Every now and again I'll trip over myself in my brain, trying to think of the right name. Which, yeah, I like this one. There was something good about it. Something nice about it. Chris just trying to get them together is just... He felt very vulnerable in this episode. I like that vulnerability to him. He was even really teary at the end. Like when they were becoming ghosts, you know? And I think people see him differently now. Now that they know that he's their nephew, their attitudes are changing. And I feel like they're softer towards him and more understanding towards him. And it's changed the dynamic, which makes me feel more glowy about it all. Instead of him being, hey, we gotta kill this demon. And they're going to kind of go, nah, Chris, geez, Chris, what now? It's more of a sort of a, there's more care there when they're talking to him. So I like that. And also the him talking about his father not really being around for him and having like that sort of abandonment feeling, and that also explains how sort of distant him and Leo were, or how much they butted heads all through since he's appeared, because there's that lingering sense of my father abandoned me, you know. So all of that is so consistent, and I really like that, because sometimes the show isn't consistent, or they introduce things in one episode that have never existed before and we're just supposed to accept them as canon, and it's very jarring. But this Leo Chris thing has been consistent from the very beginning, as far as I can remember. It feels right anyway. It doesn't feel weird. Like there is a case, like if in this episode Chris talks about being abandoned and never really having him around, and we haven't seen any sign of that in previous episodes, I'd be like, oh, where did that come from? But because of all the butting of heads and the attitude towards them both, the kind of spiky relationship they had initially, It all ties in very well. And the growing friendship. Now in this episode, were they going to kick him back to the future? Sure. That was a little thing they sprinkled in to this one, but I think they even sprinkled it in an episode or two ago too. But that was just to for spell purposes. Anyway, do you think Leo and Piper will know about Chris before they get back together? If I was writing it, I would say no. I would say don't have them know about it. Because that kind of affects it. And they feel like they have to do it. You know? We have to sleep together or otherwise Chris will die. Whereas if they don't, if they're kept in the dark and they do it organically and naturally, and then we tell them, I think that's a better way to do it, but I'm willing to accept anyway. I'm glad they didn't do it magically in this episode anyway. And the next episode is called what was it? It was like the courting of, it was something about Wyatt's father, the courting of Wyatt's father, something like that. The courtship of Wyatt's father. What a strange title. Oh, and this episode, now I'm kind of getting an idea for why it felt so nice and bubbly and lovely. It was a Valentine's Day episode. It aired the day after Valentine's Day. So that's nice. Anyway, thank you for watching. We'll be back for the courtship next time. And hey. Hey, one last question before I go. Where did Phoebe, after she broke up with Jason, have to order and purchase a new bed? Because didn't Piper chuck out all her bedroom stuff, including the bed? Same with Paige, right? I didn't see a bed in that exercise room. So now that both Paige and Phoebe are going to be back in the house, they're going to have to buy frickin' beds and all sorts of furniture. Because Piper chucked them all out. Or, alternatively, forget that episode where Piper did that, because we'll never see that exercise room again. Just pretend it never happened, like I was doing anyway. Remember when the writers tried to convince us that Phoebe would be living in Hong Kong for a few seasons, and nobody believed them? Remember that? I don't remember it. Never happened. Right. I'll see you next time.